What is going on, guys? It is your boy TKD123 Baker Video, and today we are going over our first album of 2018. This is an album that came out back in February last year, but unfortunately I slept on it. And as I was looking through and trying to organize my list for top R&B and top rap albums of 2017, I just wanted to look and see like how many of my picks were on, a lot of other people's and a lot of other magazines and publications and websites, and see if our lists were somewhat the same, you know. But the album that kept popping up on like a lot of lists, you know, amongst SZA, amongst Janae Aiko, amongst G Jordan, etc., was this album here that we are going to review this week. So without further ado, let's resume and let's go on with Sampha's Process. Now, this album came out back in February, so again, it's almost nearly a year old, so I am definitely late to the party. And I have heard of Sampha. I've definitely, just been at least somewhat knowing of him through different songs, etc., and stuff like that. And I think he's done some producing as well. I don't think that's like 100%, but I feel like I've definitely seen some songs credited for him being a producer and stuff like that. But, this came out back in February, so again, I'm late to the party. And, I feel, at least on my first impression, obviously, you know, this is the first impression and everything. There is definitely a reason for why he has been put on so many top 10 lists, top 5 lists of the year for 2017 in terms of R&B. Because this album sounds really, really great. It sounds really good. It's relatively short as well. I think it's around 40 minutes long. I think around like 10 tracks. I don't have it right here in front of me because I'm recording on my phone, obviously. But, it is a relatively short album. It's not necessarily too long. I think it's like 40 minutes, something like that. So we've been on a weird streak lately where we are picking albums that are pretty short. Not, just because and reviewing short albums, just because they just turn out to be short, which is totally not. I would rather have a super, super long album. But, overall, the features, at least for me personally, I don't think they stand out as much. I'm not, hearing a lot of features on it. And if there isn't any features, and there you go, that's exactly why. But, overall, if I were to, somehow compare Sampha to another artist, right? He's definitely sounds a lot like James Fauntleroy. Of course, we heard him in Control last year, and he is definitely more on the side of producing and stuff like that. And he's had a few EPs here and there on SoundCloud, but nothing really official in terms of albums or whatever and stuff like that. But I definitely do like James Fauntleroy. I like his style. I think he sounds great and everything. And I feel that Sampha here and James Fauntleroy have a lot of the same kind of sounding R&B tones and singing, in their songs respectively and in their projects respectively. So definitely feel like they're definitely comfortable in that sense. With just a little bit more just on, Process, this project that we are reviewing this week, I will say that, it is very, very, very somber, but very refreshing, and it's very atmospheric. What I mean by that is that, there are, a lot of very, very sad undertones and sad themes being brought up here on Process and everything, but, it's refreshing in the sense that, like, I can further on and go explain this when I get a better grasp of what I'm feeling, but I feel like a lot of these songs here, at least from the, 1.5 tractors that I've listened through, there is definitely a sense of atmosphere and sense of, like, there are a lot of differing sounds from a song-to-song basis, and it adds a little bit more of, like, a depth to the actual song. So imagine, like, you are in a very, very small room and someone's talking, like, they're just talking. But when you have a big room, you have a lot of things going on. Like, you might have, a dining room, or you have, glasses, banging up against each other. You might have silverware. You might have, plates being set down. Like, there's a lot more that goes into, like, a bigger restaurant, for example, as opposed to a smaller one, where, like, you might hear a lot of the, you might hear a lot more, things in a bigger and more atmospheric environment as opposed to a more closed down one like we have here and like a lot of different projects, I'd say. So definitely this album definitely does that, has that going on, where there is like a lot of things going on a track basis, and that's what mainly grabbed me and everything. And overall, I think his voice sounds great and everything, and I can't wait to keep listening here and get some more thoughts here going on in the album and everything. And I really do just like also the just the overall concept of the concepts of some of his songs as well are very, very unique and very cool. How he feels like he's melting, like where it's the intro track, it's 100 degrees Celsius plastic, something like that, and like it's just kind of a metaphor for like him melting and stuff like that. So definitely do enjoy that aspect. And overall, I think I'll end up really, really enjoying this project. You know, I'm really, really enjoying it right now. I'm really liking it. I think it's great. I think it sounds awesome overall. And I will check back with you guys on part two probably tomorrow. I'll see what, you know, I'll see what I gotta do. I think I have a little bit of driving to do tomorrow for work and stuff like that. So I'll definitely check back in, and you will get your review later at the end of the week. What is going on, guys? It is part two of the process review of Sampha. Sampha put out a great tape in the beginning of 2017. New year, guys. New year. New year, new me. All that good stuff. But, you know, he put out this album February 2017. I slept on it criminally. You guys heard my whole spiel in part one, whatever. But this is part two of the review. And, you know, I'm going to be honest with you guys. I'll be straight up honest here, okay? I definitely see why this is on a lot of people's top R&B list of 2017. I totally get it. I'm not gonna say that it shouldn't be there. I'm not gonna say that it doesn't deserve it, because it absolutely does. You know, this album is great, obviously, and I'm thoroughly enjoying it, all that good stuff. And overall, I definitely do understand why this made a lot of people's list. You know what I'm saying? Definitely do get 100%. Now, there are a lot of songs that I'm enjoying so far. Like Blood on Me, that one is probably my favorite track of the whole thing, just because it sounds so cool. It's a nice opening to the actual album and everything. I definitely am enjoying that one. I like Reverse Faults as well. And I also love, I forgot what the song's called, but it's about, you know, no one knows him like the piano in his mother's home. You know, how he used to play back in his childhood. I'm presuming that's kind of what the whole song's about, you know. But that one I like as well and everything. And overall, I'm definitely enjoying it. You know, it definitely does show its length after a few more playthroughs. Like, I may be on probably three or four playthroughs, something like that. And I definitely am feeling how short it is. It is very, very short. So that is a thing to consider as well going into this. It's just that, you know, it is 40 minutes and it's literally 40 minutes. You know what I'm saying? So there is that. And overall, you know, just one thing that kind of I feel like I'm going to end up feeling about this album is that it is very repetitive, right? Obviously, that's a weird critique, just because, you know, I'm obviously listening to it throughout the week and everything, and it's very much of a concentrated listen. So, you know, obviously, there will come a point where I'm going to say, you know, almost every project, every album I review is repetitive, but I think here we have a different case. Now, you know, we have had albums in the past where, you know, they feel repetitive just because, you know, I feel that the artist just has a certain style or has a certain, you know, sound that they want to project in a given project. And I feel like here is a perfect example. I feel like, you know, a lot of this album definitely does sound a little bit similar, sounds, you know, a little bit too much of a kind of medium, you know, way of, you know, styling and really arranging the songs and everything and how the song's produced and everything. They definitely do sound a little bit on the samey same in the majority of the album, I'd say. Obviously, there are the ones that derive differently. Like for me, I think, you know, track two, one of my favorites, Blood on Me, that one definitely is kind of a deviation towards the main type of song that we get here on this project. And, you know, that's neither here or there. A lot of people would, you know, try to defend that and say that, you know, it's their style, whatever, etc., all that good stuff. But, you know, me personally, I think that it kind of just makes the album a little bit less interesting, in my opinion. You know, obviously, it's great. I'm, you know, thoroughly, you know, just loving the album and everything. And, like, you know, I'm just not, like, adored with it. Like, I'm not, like, amazed by it. Like, I guarantee maybe, like, 2 weeks out, I probably won't even bump this. You know, and that's not saying that the quality is bad. It's just that, you know, it's just not the diversity that I like to see personally in different albums and stuff like that. So that's been my part two of Sampha's process. I will get into part three and my final thoughts over in a few days' time, probably tomorrow, I think. I always say that. I always say that at the part two, oh, yeah, but we do it tomorrow because, you know, whatever. But I'll catch you guys on part three.
What is going on, y'all? We have a beard change here. I just shaved, like, just now. So that's a little awkward, but beside the point, we are going to finalize a review here of part 3 on Process by Sampha and everything. And I've said a lot of things about this album. I feel like I've talked like a ton about this album this week. But, you know, I still hold the testament that I had in my part 2 review that I feel like, you know, yes, this is a good album. This is, you know, a very, very good R&B album. And it definitely is worthy of winning those top 10 spots of last year and everything, stuff like that, on everyone else's list. Not mine, because I slept on it. But I will say that, you know, this album does sound a bit repetitive, at least to me personally, you know. And you can take that either good or bad, like I said before, but at least from my standpoint, I look for a little variety in my tapes and everything. But that does not mean that, you know, this album doesn't have its gems. There are two tracks here that I did not even bring up at all, which I'm surprised really didn't, and that is Timmy's Prayer and Incomplete Kisses. Those two songs, especially Timmy's Prayer, there is a nice guitar type of like it's almost like someone's just flicking the guitar. Like there's that on the instrumental that is just so good. I love that so much, honestly. Like, that's really one of the best instrumentals I've heard in a very, very long time. I love that on Timmy's Prayer. And also Incomplete Kisses, I just like the concept of it. It's a great, you know, I just like the concept that you could talk for hours about it, where it's that meaning of, like, you know, you just kiss a girl, but then there's just something that just isn't right. You know, I feel like a lot of people can relate to that. That's definitely why I feel like this album, and really, you know, that song more specifically is one of the one that a lot of people talk about when talking about this album and everything. But, you know, overall, you know, this project was great in my opinion. I liked it a lot. Yes, it was repetitive. That's probably my only, you know, gripe against it. But overall, I will be checking out Sampha a little more closer in 2018, seeing what he does. Hopefully he drops a project that we can freshly review and stuff like that, other than pull from a 2017 album and everything. And, you know, overall, I do recommend it. You know, check it out. It is on Spotify. It is on Apple Music. Definitely go stream that. And definitely stream one of the best R&B albums of 2017. Or you can call it electronic. Like, it's labeled under Apple Music. It's under electronic. But to me, you know, it sounds a little more R&B. But who am I? Whatever. I'm just a dude that makes videos. And with that being said, I hope you all enjoyed the video. If you want to join, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and turn down below. I appreciate all the videos give me. And also make sure to check out on my Twitter. I post during the morning, like maybe Monday or Tuesday, something like that, like one of those mornings where I will, you know, link out the album that we are going to be listening to this week, and you can listen on with me, and then you can, you know, just post your comments and thoughts about it at the end of the week when it goes up during the weekend. So thank you all for watching, and as always, I got you.